textiles were kind of like the grandparent of contemporary technologies because it's such a potent historical form of binary code. I'm really fascinated by this material that can both have industrial applications and artistic exploration. On the side, which is nice. Being at MIT means coming back to where these early interactions between craftspeople and engineers first occurred. There's like a really ripe environment for creating new technologies and ideas together. My work often deals with considering past lives or narratives that are kind of woven into the material directly. In some cases, I work with conductive materials in order to weave them into textiles that can respond to the viewer.
Future Sketches is concerned with what are tools that artisan designers in the future will be using, and specifically tools that involve computation. It's really using software in the service of making art. And Chloe's coming at it from a perspective of materials and trying to connect with electronics and sensing in different ways to tell stories. It's really exploring the relationship of textiles and computation, and there's this long and rich history here at MIT.
Whirlwind's primary storage, or memory, consists of 32 planes of magnetic cores.
Initially, magnetic core memory was made in the underground levels of MIT by women who were actually former textile laborers here in New England. Magnetic core memory is made from copper, yarn, and depending on what current is passed through the X or the Y axis, some cores were magnetized and coded for a 1, and others were not and coded for a 0. It represents the last moment in computing history where you can actually see a programming language binary code in a tangible form. It's really meaningful to me because a lot of my work deals with how meaning or how information is stored within materials in invisible ways. How do we come up with a contemporary technology inspired by the historical technology? Can we make a textile that can be actuated by touch, but then also have a magnetic response and in some way kind of shapeshift? The two layers are kind of cool. You have this like slight variation.
I'm Vera van der Sijp. I'm a master's student at Future Sketches in the Media Lab. My background is in graphic design, and so I do a lot with typography. With Chloe, she's looking at fibers and basically how to actuate the fabric that she's gonna make, so how it will respond to input, but also maybe a change, and how she'll incorporate text.
You can weave magnets in the textile. This has.
She really advocates for craft as a driver for innovative products or different ways to approach computation or working with fabrics.
This is a TC2 loom. It allows for weavers to upload a digital file, and it converts pixels into individual yarns so that the number of pixels corresponds to the number of ends per inch.
Computation is getting smaller and smaller and smaller, more harder to see, more invisible, and artists and designers can make these things visible. They can show us the story of what is part of our everyday life.
When you make technologically advanced work, craft is not always the first thing on people's minds, but it can really be a driving force for innovative ideas.
It's better to be thicker because thinner wise can't.
Oh, it can't. It fries. Turns out creating a magnetic field within the context of a textile is very difficult. I think actually making something that works isn't the most successful aspect of a collaboration. I actually think developing a relationship of mutual respect and also having the dialogue shift one's perspective on their own medium, to me, is probably the most successful form of collaboration. I'm particularly excited about having medical or technical applications of this research because I think it's like a wonderful way to be in the world that I'm exploring both how the work impacts or touches humans on a more poetic or emotional level, and then thinking about also how it can help someone live a better life.